Story Wednesday.
If you read about Fisher Spassky in 1972, because the Russians own chess, owned it, world championship, fucking Bobby Fischer, how he fucking, I think, forfeited the first game, and it's the championship match against the world champion.
And that gave us Moscow, and we were able to then own the Soviet Union after that.
Yeah, they owned...
Oh, that's right. It didn't make a shit bit of difference. It wasn't important during the Cold War.
They own chess, but they don't own...
Who cared?
They own chess, but they don't own blue jeans. But I'd rather own the
blue jeans. Was that the day before or after we were going to the moon again? I'm trying to remember
that
when people were like playing chess. Were we? Did we go to the moon before or just after that for the third or fourth time?
The Russians are going to the moon, right? I heard.
Yeah, a little behind. Yeah, they're going to give that a whirl. Good luck to you.
I think
that poor bastard's just going to be this skeleton, either sitting on the moon or orbiting around it. Happy Russian cosmonaut, just sitting there, a skeleton in a capsule.
That was the great thing, if you ever really hear about their space program. The difference, we got there because we were so determined and united and stuff.
Yeah.
They got there because they have no regard for human life.
Just, it was like
hundreds and hundreds of dudes died.
Yeah.
And still floating around in capsules.
Hell yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
And we had our space program was pretty much like, we're not putting a human being on top of this fucking missile, this explosive.
Yeah.
It's just, it's not going to happen until we know there's a good chance that he's going to get into orbit.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Russians, the Reds put a man in orbit first because they didn't give a shit if Stanislav fucking burnt up. They had an explosion in their space program that fucking wiped out so many people and the bunker system that was supposed to protect them, they were wiped out.
Yep.
That's how big this explosion was. They didn't give a shit.
No, they
have guys
going
up there floating around, Lou?
Yeah, I want to get back into that.
I'm kind of making
it's
that
like
up.
You know what it is, though? Things are so classic. Their space program's so classified. They have had some, you know, deaths in their space program.
A bunch.
So have we. But, I mean, I would not doubt for a second there isn't some fucking something that ends with SKI on the uniform wrapped around a skeleton.
Yeah, I'm sure there is. There's got to be.
Kind of hands on the controls, just zipping around.
When one of our pilots, one of our astronauts die, they're heroes, and it's a whole, they stop the space program for a few years.
Yeah, years.
And there's a whole funeral
investigations
in Arlington Cemetery. One of their guys died, they just announced on, Comrade Dostoevsky fell on a pillow, and he's fine.
Yes, it was glorious. Return to Mother of Russia, where he has now been given a large piece of land to work the farm as his own.
Yes.
Meanwhile, he's the fucking dead. They killed his family so they don't spill the beans.
And they turn to the next cosmonaut and go, "It's your turn, goddamn!
Yes.
It's your turn, you get in, you faggot!
Get there! What are you waiting for?"
Hey, we got to go to Drudge, by the way. Speaking of Russia, I don't think they have a government anymore.
What happened?
I think they dissolved their government overnight.
Well, the prime minister fucking...
what's
resigned.
Going on?
Well, prime minister resigned, and it's actually over chess. There was
for a second, I looked at Jimmy's eyes like, oh, my God, if this is true, I am so fucked.
Well, the prime minister did resign. I don't know why. How about Putin? Putin, whatever.
Putin dissolves the Russian government.
Yeah, no, this is Putin. It's not them having no government. It's him taking over everything.
You know something?
Putin is going back to the Soviet Union.
To the Soviet Union.
Yeah,
he started getting he's got the bombers up again.
They got a new missile system that he's developing. They got new nukes. He's got those bomber planes.
He's got the bombers that are now being tailed by England's planes. And if they start cruising around Alaska again, we're going to have to send our guys up.
We're going to have to repoint. You know our missiles are pointed away from
I know.
To bring back Russia as we know it?
I hope so.
That's what he said.
So they look at this like we look at radio stations, like they knew that Free FM was a bad idea and they're bringing back the rock.
They're consolidating. They're going back to rock.
Is that what's going on? It's like radio stations. They decided, format sucked. Let's go back to what we know.
We go back to rock.
Radio chick was nobody cares. Bullshit.
No one wants to listen to the talk radio. Oh,
Nick DiPaolo, good, you know, but they can't just build up.
But they had to kill him. Can only be one show in charge.
Welcome back, Soviet Union.
Welcome back.
Welcome back. The rest of the world has been a bunch of cocksuckers ever since they dissolved.
Treated the United States like shit.
Yeah.
Because we were the ones that got rid of the other bad boy on the block. Now fun.
We need the Soviet Union right now.
We absolutely do.
They need to fight the Arabs for us.
Yes.
They're the ones who killed Hitler. We did not beat Hitler. I mean,
let me tell you something. The whole world
couldn't beat Hitler, and Russia did it because same reason they won the space program.
So they're
because
not,
they were willing to walk. They lost millions. Way more dudes than anybody else.
Just because they did
they
that
like
doesn't mean
people.
That they're you know that they're all bad.
No, that's what I'm saying is that now they're going to use their crazy life doesn't matter mentality to kill the Muslims while we sit back and get the praise.
Hey, I think we got to play.
Poor guy was beaten anyway.
Yeah.
Just let him friggin', you know,
yeah.
hang out in his bunker.
I think we got to play a sting
Put him on
today.
Display. That's what they wanted to do, but Hitler said, no, I'm poisoning myself and then burn me. I shan't be in some Russian museum.
No, that sucks. It would have been awesome.
Oh, imagine seeing the Hitler stuffed Hitler.
I saw Lenin. I've been to Moscow. I saw Lenin.
You saw the stuffed Lenin?
Yeah.
How does he look?
Freakiest thing you ever saw.
How does he look?
He is like a pancake. He's all spread out.
Is he? Is he flattening out?
His body is flattening out.
Oh, it's fucked up.
The only things they're working on is the head and hands.
That's all they want to preserve?
The hands are kind of stuck out like Mickey Mouse's hands, and they're gray. And his head is, he's laying back on this red pillow.
Yeah.
And he has this, that's sleeping really hard sleep, like he's having a bad dream forever. Like his eyebrows are furrowed. And he just looks upset.
Yeah.
And you go in there, it's really fucking weird because you go in and it's all red lighting, the whole tomb. And you go down and there's soldiers every couple of feet who tell you to keep your hands out of your pockets and be respectful and you can't take a picture.
And you can't take a picture.
Yeah, you got to keep moving, too.
Like, smile.
Yeah.
put your arm around the glass thing.
Yeah, you can't.
Why no pocket?
And he's this, because it's disrespectful to, like, have your hands, you have to walk very formally. And
so you can't put your dick on his lip.
And you can't put your dick on his lip.
Take pictures of it.
You can't.
Why go?
Yeah, exactly.
Why go?
And he's in this glass case with these red jewels on it. It's really strange. And then you go and you realize there's a huge line all day, every day. And
wow.
They're all just there to see a dead guy. That's what you realize. When
it's
you get
not
there.
Like, wow, this is Lenin. This is history. This is communist. It's just, I want to see a dead guy and what he looks like after so long.
Yeah.
And they still preserve, like, the whole red commie thing, even though they were pretty much not for that anymore.
Well, good thing. No. Now that they're coming back.
Well, they're coming back with a vengeance.
They don't have to change the lighting scheme anywhere.
That's it. Yeah. Coming back.
Yeah, you don't even have to change the logo.
Nope.
Logo's still there.
Good.
Awful Me from Whack Bag. Sweet. Russian wrestling villains again.
Oh, yep. Yeah.
Bring back the Russian wrestling villains.
Yeah, so Rocky can fight another Russian now.
There you go.
So the rest of this goddamn world can look and say, oh, my God. The United States, could you protect us against these? Remember when you used to put missiles in our countries and you'd station troops to keep the Russians from coming? Could you please come back and do that again? Oh, what? The scumbags of the world? Us? That does show our force everywhere? Ooh, go fuck you. Deal with it yourself now. Watch him just get fucking goose stepped over by those guys.
Oh, yeah.
Is the Russian army, you think, going to be bigger than the French army?
The Russians could fucking kill the French
with guns.
Like three soldiers. Yeah.
They could just roll up their sleeves.
That crying French guy when the Nazis are coming in. That's the definitive picture to me of France. Till today. I don't even mean historically. That old French guy just going. While the Nazis are just like goose stepping. Their way into Paris. Pick up a gun, faggot. Guy's crying with a baguette in his hand and his stupid beret.
Wow.
Oh, good. I welcome you, Soviet Union. Please come back.
What do we get to bring back? Because Russia's coming back.
Dolph Rundgren.
What else? We get
Dolph.
All right, that's good.
Dolph gets a career again.
Those Chechnyans are going to have to keep their fucking ass in line now,
they
too.
They shut the fuck up.
No more busting into schools with explosives.
I interrupted your rant before, but I'm thinking we should, play a Sting song today. He was all about singing about the ugly Russians.
Two words. Yakov Smirnov.
Ah.
There we go. He's got it back.
What a country. You know, in New Soviet Union, they rip your tongue out.
I don't know what Sting
song. I opened for him once.
Did you?
I opened for him
Hopefully
after.
His head.
I opened for him in the 90s after it had come down and everything.
Oh, what was his act?
Just, my wife is crazy. She's nuts. Like, it was all just wife and kids.
Wife and kids. Take my wife, please.
Yes, please.
I
Did he have an audience?
Russia.
It was like half. It was the DC Improv, and it was like nobody there years ago.
They now we, you know, no more. Good night. Thank you. Let's see, Russia.
Russians. I don't know if this is the song. I remember it was ominous back in the day.
Was it?
Yeah, this might be it with the. Yeah, see the Russians.
Down clock.
Yeah, they're scary.
Yeah,
scary people back then.
Hey, it's a Christmas song.
Oh, it does sound like Christmas.
On Christmas Day.
What is this shit? I hate this thing.
Stop, I know.
Is he trying to have a Russian accent?
Oh, boy.
How can I save my little boy from Oppenheimer's deadly toy? There is no monopoly of common sense on either side of the political fence. We share the same biology, regardless of ideology.
Oh, boy.
So that's what ended the, that's what ended the Cold War, right? That song?
Yeah.
That's what did it.
That song and Chess.
Because everybody heard it and said,
oh, boy, we got to protect the children.
Yeah, and ideology rhymes with the other things.
Biology.
Was it biology?
Yeah.
I like that song.
That's the same rhyme.
Another song for your iPod there, Jimmy.
Oh, piece of shit song.
Hello.
What did he do? Putin dissolved a Russian government.
Yep.
Good boy.
Dissolution is expected to result in a new prime minister who will be seen as Putin's choice to succeed him after he steps down.
That's what folks just like what Hitler did. It's the exact same thing.
So he's like supposed to step down or, you know, his term is up or whatever the hell it is. So instead of just letting this election process go, he dissolves the government and says, I'll put this guy in charge.
He didn't want to deal with that pesky election.
Yeah,
that dumb election.
This is what Hitler did. The way he took power is fascinating because it was like a system just like ours. It was a parliamentary system, not like ours. Like, and he just used politics to get himself made pure. Like he got enough guys in his party, and they kept walking out on every vote, so that they had a non-functioning government, and they couldn't pass anything because you needed a certain, you know, it's like you need 2/3 or something.
Mm-hmm.
So he just kept doing all these weird little games, and people had to do a little more and more, and he got more and more seats. And then
weird little games too amounted to a few brown shirts beating the shit out of everybody that was voting against who he wanted.
Yeah. That would be great if they still.
Putin is the Sith Lord? Holy shit. Just found that out. Also, Russia tests super strength bomb is also on a drudge because.
What can you call a super strength
bomb?
It's a big round black bomb with a witch sticking out of it.
Yeah. They're calling that because it's the most powerful non nuke bomb.
This bomb will completely make your face all black and your hair grow up. Your hair will grow
up. I
will
hide
funny.
It in a box with a ribbon and a bow on it, and then you open it up.
Some will be put in cigars, which will peel back like banana.
And your eyes will go googly, and your teeth will be all knocked out.
We have to, we'll still work on it, because all it takes is a few shakes of head, and you're back to normal. the father of all bombs is what they're calling it.
Well, it can't be that if it's new. It'd have to be an old bomb.
Russia has tested the world's most powerful vacuum bomb, which unleashes a destructive shockwave with the power of a nuclear blast. It's the father of all bombs. It's the latest in the new series of Russian weapons.
Yep, they got all new weapons now.
Let's hope they use it in the Middle East somewhere. How nice would that be?
Mm-hmm.
Although they're friends with Iran. That's
they usually are. Well, yeah.
That's what they're waiting for, one of us to like decide Iran's doing too much with their nuclear program, bomb them, and then
North
they
Korea,
step in.
Russia. And Iran.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, it's a nightmare.
Nice axis of evil.
It's a nightmare.
Nice axis of evil.
That's a good solid team.
Yeah.
Just put the shades down and hope nothing happens outside your window.
Yeah. It would be great if the axis of evil had made a press conference like with the logo. Like they said, oh, we're taking up the name and we are.
There it is.
The Axis of Evil.
They're the Axis of Evil.
you see their newest, whatever, Russia just signed. Basically, the Axis of Evil just signed Russia. Yeah. So Putin shows up with a jersey, taking, you know, kind of a shiny smile
huge.
With a jersey.
With the Axis of Evil hat on. He's got the cap on. Very happy to be with the Axis of Evil.
Pick. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. He's a new draft pick.
Yeah.
Kim On Jill or whatever his name is has his arm around him.
Yeah.
Always wanted this again, let's go.
I just really hope I can contribute to this ball club and kill all Americans. And
jerseys and hats made for the fans.
Oh, God.
All right.
Much stronger Looking than hard. Our bombs. Stop it.
Well, good luck, bro, to Russia.
Good. Now we get to build more better bombs. Big, better bombs.
Hey, loser.